Hello, my name is Mike, and I want to show you how to create a custom search form for your own data in WordPress. This video is actually an update to an older one already made. I'll link to it below as it has a different example for the data, but I wanted to show off some newer features Formidable has added since that video was uploaded. Let's get started. First, I'd like to go over what this search form will actually be searching. It's this team directory right here, being displayed in a Formidable view on this page. The view for it is here in the Views section, and you can add new team members with this form. Every new submission of this form will be added to the view, which will be displayed on that first page. I got these straight from the team directory template in Applications, if you wanted to start with something similar, or any of these other ones, or build your own. This channel has lots of examples of applications you can build with no coding knowledge using Formidable Forms, and this search form we'll build will work for any of them. Let's go back to the page with the team directory. We have a picture, then a first name, a last name, and a job title. I want people to be able to search for any of those last three, so we need to make a form to do so. The form itself is pretty straightforward. I'll start with a new blank form and call it Team Directory Search. And I'll put it in our Team Directory application. We'll need three text fields, a first name, a last name, and a job title. And because I don't want this search form to get too big, I'll drag these fields next to each other so they take up less room on the page. So far, so good. But this is where it gets a little different. In the advanced area for each field, we're going to add some text. Under default value in the first name field, I'm going to put git param equals fname in brackets. I'll copy and paste it into the other two fields, changing fname to lname and job. Why am I doing this? This is going to save what the users search for as parameters in the URL, letting the Formidable view on the page that displays the data filter it all. It'll make more sense as we do more to make it work. Hit update to save, and then let's go to the settings of our form. First, while we're in general, scroll down and hit the checkbox to submit the form with Ajax. That way it won't refresh the whole page on a search. Also, check the box for do not store entries submitted from this form. Because one, it's a search form for an employee directory, so you probably don't want the data, but two, it will let the same person search for the same thing more than once. Then in buttons, let's change the word submit to search, just to make it clearer what this form does. Then go to actions and notifications. We're going to change the default confirmation action from show message to redirect to URL. Right here, I'm going to paste the URL of the page that displays the view. So I'm going to go to that page and copy it, and then paste it. After the final backslash, we need to add those parameters. So first put a question mark, and then type fname, our first parameter, then equals, and then click the short code for our first name field. Don't worry about this sanitize URL part. If you don't know what this means, just know that it's added security. Then type an and or ampersand sign, and then lname equals, and then the last name shortcode, and then another and job equals, and then the job title shortcode. So what this is doing is saving whatever the user enters into those three fields as the fname, lname, and job parameters into the URL of the page that the team directory is on. Then, we can filter the team directory by these parameters. Okay, great. Let's hit update to save our search form. We're pretty close. Let's go to our view to make sure it's filtered by these parameters. Click Filter Entries. Then we'll choose the fields it's displaying. Name is first name, and because it's a text field, we'll change the is equal to like, and in the value, we'll again put git param equals fname in brackets. Then we'll do the same thing for last name and job title, using the same parameter abbreviations. Okay, let's update to save. Now we just need to put our form on the Team Directory page. So let's go to that page and hit Edit. I'm going to add a Formidable Form block and then choose our form, and I'll move it above the view. In the original video, this form was embedded inside the view itself, so it was always stuck at either the top or bottom of the data. But that's not necessary. Before we preview it, if you'd rather put the form somewhere else, like in the sidebar or something, just use the short code for the form. You can find the short code under Embed and then Insert manually. All right, let's check out this search form. Here it is, and here's the data. Let's search for somebody. It worked. What about if we wanted to search for somebody's job title instead? Yep. And if we wanted to see everybody again, does clearing the data work? Yep. A custom search form for your data, nice and easy. And that's how you make a custom search form in WordPress with Formidable Forms. Subscribe for more form building and WordPress tips, and I'll see you next time.